deriving lower bounds for the communication complexity of functions can be a tedious exercise. But we have quite powerful general techniques for this as well. And one such technique is called the rank technique. The rank technique is based on a theorem which states that the number of monochromatic combinatorial rectangles you need to partition a matrix that corresponds to a function f is at least 2 times the rank of that matrix minus 1. The proof of this theorem is not too complicated, it just requires a little bit of linear algebra. So here's how the proof works. Say we have a combinatorial rectangle R, then we can define a matrix that describes that combinatorial rectangle. The matrix would have ones wherever the combinatorial rectangle is present and zero in all the other locations. And it's easy to see that the rank of such a matrix is equal to 1. Let O be the set of monochromatic rectangles that cover all the 1 entries in our matrix that corresponds to the function f. Now, we can write down this matrix MF to be equal to the sum of all these matrices that correspond to these combinatorial rectangles. So MF is just equal to the sum over all R in O of MR. There's an alternative way in which we can define what MF is or express MF. And that is by using the zero entries. So let's say Z is a set of monochromatic rectangles that cover the zero entries. How can we now express MF? We can express MF by starting with a matrix that has ones written everywhere, and then we subtract all the rectangles that cover the zero entries. So we start with a matrix that is all ones. Let's call this matrix J. And now we say that MF is equal to this matrix that contains ones everywhere, J, minus all the combinatorial rectangles that cover the zero entries. So we subtract the sum of all MR, where R is out of Z. So these are 2 different ways of expressing the matrix MF. Now we are interested in the rank of that matrix. So the rank of MF clearly is just the rank of the sum of R in O over MR. And the rank is subadditive, meaning that we can pull the rank function into the sum, and the result is a quantity that only gets bigger. That's a simple fact from linear algebra. So this is less or equal to the sum over R and O of rank of MR. And we know that the rank of MR is 1. So what's written here is really just the size of the set O. We can do a similar thing for the second way of expressing MF. So the rank of MF is also equal to the rank of this all ones matrix minus the sum of R and Z over MR. And we do the same thing as before, and we determine that this is less or equal to 1 plus the size of Z. The only thing left to do is to sum up both of those inequalities, and we get that 2 times the rank of MF is less or equal to 1 plus Z plus O. Or we can rearrange this and say that 2 times the rank of MF minus 1 is less or equal to O plus that. And O plus that, I mean, that's just all the monochromatic rectangles that cover 1 entries and all the monochromatic rectangles that cover 0 entries. So that's the number of monochromatic rectangles we have, which is C of F. And this proves the entire theorem. This theorem is very useful because now we can determine how many monochromatic combinatorial rectangles we need, at least, to cover a certain matrix for a function, just by looking at the rank of that matrix. For example, let us consider the equality function again. The matrix that corresponds to the equality function is just the identity matrix. We have ones on the diagonal because, well, if Alice and Bob have the same input, that's a diagonal entry in the matrix, and then we have a 1, and we have zeros everywhere else. What is the rank of this matrix? The identity matrix has full rank, so the rank is equal to the number of columns or rows of the matrix. So the question is, how many columns or rows does this matrix have? If Alice and Bob both get an bit string of length n, then we need to look at all possible combinations of bit strings of length n. There are 2 to the n many such bit strings. Therefore, the matrix has 2 to the n many rows and 2 to the n many columns. And therefore, the rank of this matrix is 2 to the n. We now apply our theorem, the rank technique. We know that the rank of the matrix is 2 to the n, and therefore we know that to cover all the entries in this matrix with the monochromatic combinatorial rectangles, we need at least 2 times the rank of this matrix minus 1 many such rectangles. The rank of the matrix is 2 to the n, so we get 2 times 2 to the n minus 1 many rectangles at least. That's 2 to the n plus 1. Minus 1. And we know that the communication complexity of a function is the log of C of f. So we know that the communication complexity of this particular function, the equality function, has to be the log of 2 to the n plus 1 minus 1, which is n plus 1 if we also take into account the fact that the communication complexity needs to be an integer number. Of course, we already know that this is also optimal, because the naive solution, where Alice just sends all her input to Bob, Bob does a computation and gives the result back to Alice, also requires n plus 1 bits. So n plus 1 bits is possible, and we also have a lower bound of n plus 1, so this result is tight.